Hey Lore Lovers, welcome back to Liondrag. Today we discuss about the second part of this series, where I'm trying to introduce you as best as I can to this awesome universe of Warhammer 40k. In the first part we have discussed about the Emperor and its serving institutions and armies, but now let's continue with Chaos, often referred to as the Primordial Truth or the Primordial Annihilator, is a metaphysical force embodied by malevolent entities in the Immaterium, fueled by emotional energy. Predominantly comprised of demons, Chaos extends to mortals pursuing its goals, ranging from Chaos Cultists to Mighty Chaos Space Marines and traitor Tainted Lynges. Chaos is also the turbulent psychic energy in the alternate dimension called the Immaterium, shaping the individual Chaos God's nightmare domains, collectively known as the Realm of Chaos. Chaos is synonymous with the Warp, a notion of spiritual, psychic and emotional energy underlying the material universe. It is a potent force of change and power, corrupting both physically and spiritually. While not inherently evil, Chaos often leads its adherents to malevolent acts. Devotees may seek freedom and change, but the pursuit of excess and personal gain often results in damnation. Psykers, the most evolutionarily advanced mortals, tap into Chaos's energy, granting abilities beyond standard physical laws. However, exposure to Chaos can corrupt them, turning them into unwitting slaves of the Ruinous Powers. The four great Chaos Gods, collectively known as the Ruinous Powers, represent distinct aspects of Chaos and can be worshipped individually or as Chaos Undivided. The iconic symbol of Chaos is the 8-pointed star, symbolizing infinite possibilities. Ultimately, Chaos seeks the complete destruction of the material universe, consumed by its uncontained energies. Chaos is a malevolent force representing the negative aspects of sentient beings' psyches. In the Milky Way galaxy, Chaos particularly embodies humanity's flaws, exploiting weaknesses and corrupting individuals easily. Chaos' associated dangers include mutation, demonic possession, and spiritual damnation. Despite these risks, some willingly serve Chaos for the meritocracy it offers. Chaos judges based on abilities and success in promoting the individual Chaos God's agenda. It provides the opportunity for power and respect beyond mortal dreams, offering freedom in contrast to the oppressive Imperium of Man. However, serving Chaos makes one a slave, and most who fall to its temptations face eventual failure, becoming possessed, Chaos Pawn, or mere pawns in the Dark God schemes. Chaos Space Marines, also known as Traitor Marines, Renegade Marines, or Heretic Astartes, are former Space Marines of the Imperium who have forsaken the service of the Emperor of Mankind, dedicating themselves to Chaos for personal goals. They often belong to the original Traitor Legions from the ancient Horus Heresy, or later Renegade Space Marines chapters. These corrupted Astartes can emerge from any time and place, succumbing to Chaos's allure. The Horus Heresy witnessed the split between Loyalist Space Marines and the Chaos Space Marines of the Traitor Legions, led by the corrupted Primarch Horus. Some Traitor Marines served all four Dark Gods as Chaos Undivided, while others focused on worshipping a single Ruinous Power. Chaos Space Marines, one ascetic servant of the Emperor, undergo physical and armor transformations, warping into darker, inhuman forms influenced by warp energies. Their ambitions revolve around indulging in pleasures, acquiring wealth, causing mayhem, and above all, gaining power to rule over humanity in the name of the Chaos Gods. In the wake of the Great Rift's birth, Chaos Space Marines led by Abaddon the Despoiler pose a significant threat to the Imperium. Their unity lies in an insatiable hunger for power, initially focused on specific goals but evolving into a deep obsession. While the Dark Gods reward followers for carnage, the bestowed gifts are unpredictable, ranging from empowering auras to grotesque mutations. Ultimately, Chaos Space Marines aspire for immortality, seeking to become the Demon Princes. Successful aspirants achieve this transformation, but countless failures end up as mewling abominations known as Chaos Spawn, mutated beyond recognition. The forces of Chaos, sometimes derogatorily referred to as the Archenemy, or the Renegades, or Traitors, for those one loyal to the Imperium, constitute a diverse array of mortal and demonic servants devoted to individual Ruinous Powers and the overarching concept of Chaos Undivided. While Chaos Space Marines are prominent and potent, they are bolstered by myriad other servants, human Chaos Cultists, Traitoris Militarum Soldiers, Traitor Titan Legions, Chaos Knights, Remnants of the Dark Mechanicum and Legions of Chaos Demons all contribute to the forces of Chaos. In addition to Chaos Space Marines, the Imperium labels mortal servants of Chaos, who are not transhuman Astartes, as the Lost and the Damned. This inclusive term encompasses the varied and numerous followers who have succumbed to the corrupting influence of Chaos, reflecting the vast and multifaceted nature of the archenemy. The Asuriani, or Children of Asurion, were once a dominant humanoid alien species that boasted an expansive empire across the galaxy. However, their pride and descent into hedonism precipitated a cataclysm, birthing the chaos god Slaanesh and decimating their civilization over 10 millennia ago. The surviving Asuriani, also known as Eldar or Craftor Eldari, now inhabit colossal starships called Craftworlds. These city-like vessels are their homes, and the Asuriani grapple with survival, employing mental discipline and martial prowess against the galaxy's horrors. Employing mystical technologies like spirit stones and wraithbone infinity circuits, they safeguard their souls from consumption by Slaanesh after death. The Asuriani culture distinguishes itself through the use of these technologies and the discipline system to control their darker impulses. Their history, preserved through stories and traditional arts, reveals the remnants of their once vast civilization. Physically resembling humans, the Eldari exhibit longer limbs, fine features, and slightly pointed ears. Their movements exude a unique grace, and their emotional experiences, more intense than humans, contribute to their rich artistic expressions. While their potential for joy and creativity is unparalleled, the Eldari's emotional extremes also make them susceptible to despair and darker emotions. To curb this, the Asuriani path guides them to balance their minds and pursue constructive goals, avoiding the destructive pursuit of pleasure that nearly led to their extinction. Innately psychic, the Asuriani can become powerful psychers, utilizing their abilities for technology mastery. Despite their advanced status, the Craftor Eldari face decline in the 41st millennium, existing as a mere shadow of their former glory, teetering on the brink of extinction. A craft world is a colossal planetoid-sized spacecraft that serves as the habitation for the Asuriani, an advanced humanoid faction of the Eldari species. These craft worlds traverse space at sublight speed, carrying the primary remnants of the Eldari species following their catastrophic fall. Each craft world is an autonomous realm, possessing a unique culture and sustaining itself independently. Constructed around a skeleton of psychoactive crystalline wraithbone, these structures permeate the colossal void craft, extending throughout its entire framework and forming the core of the most Asuriani constructions. The wraithbone core functions akin to the circulatory and nervous system of a living being. It serves as a self-replenishing reservoir of psychic power, with rib-like structures disrupting this energy across the craft world. Wraithbone's psychoconductive nature allows it to transmit psychic impulses, responding organically to psychic forces. The craft world, in essence, embodies a living entity fueled by psychic energy. This energy can be expanded as light and heat, crucial for the functionality of shipboard devices and Asuriani technology, reliant on the wireless psychic power grid woven into the craft world's substructure. Known as the Infinity Circuit, this metaphysical neural structure is embedded with spirit stones, holding the essence of the craft world's departed. The collective psychic energy stored in these stones serves as both the source of the craft world's power and its ethereal sentience, forming a ghostly presence within the vast vessel. The Webway, also known as the Labyrinth Dimension or Labyrinthine Dimension in older texts, stands as an extra-dimensional space secluded from the Immaterium millions of Terrans years ago by the highly advanced Xenos species called the Old Ones. Today, these intricate networks find application in the faster-than-light travel of the Eldari Asuriani from the craft worlds and their Drukhari counterpart. The Webway serves as more than a conduit for travel. It is home to the expansive dark city of Komora, and the concealed craft world governed by the enigmatic Harlequins known as the Black Library. Described as an immensely intricate network of arteries and capillaries, a radiant maze of tunnels and a mystical tapestry of concealed threads spanning the veil between real space and the warp, the Webway is a hyperdimensional construct. This construct is situated between the material realm and the turbulent currents of the warp, acting as the interstice akin to a veil cast over something unsavory. Crafted through psychic means, much like other prized Eldari artifacts, the Webway's myriad corridors are shielded from warp incursions through specific methods, manners, and the composition of their construction. This protection safeguards the stability and integrity of the Webway, allowing the Eldari to navigate its intricate pathways for swift and secure travel. The Drukhari, also known as the Dark Eldar, represent a fallen and corrupted Eldari kindred, embodying the sadistic and malevolent aspect of the Asuriani. In contrast to their cousins from the craft worlds, the Drukhari are an ancient and highly advanced alien race of the Fey humanoids. Coined by the Drukhari Archon and Supreme Overlord of Kamara, Azdrubal Vett in the 32nd millennium, the alternative term Dark Elder reflects their forsaken nature. Like their craftor and Dari counterparts, the Drukhari armies emphasize mobility and advanced technology, yet they often lack resilience and numerical strength. Infamous for reveling in privacy, enslavement and torture, the Drukhari display extreme sadism. Employing anti-gravity skimmers such as Raiders and Ravagers for high-speed attacks, they utilize the Webway, an interdimensional labyrinth, to traverse the galaxy swiftly and securely. Distinctive among the intelligent species of the Milky Way galaxy, the Drukhari do not inhabit settled worlds. Instead, their majority resides in the dark city of Kamara, within the Eldaris Webways ordered Immaterium. Predominantly pirates and slavers, the Drukhari feed on the souls of other sentient beings to satisfy their insatiable thirst, sometimes serving as mercenaries for other starfaring species. Physically, the Drukhari, particularly the warrior case, are tall, light, white-skinned humanoids, exuding a death-like pallor due to the absence of a life-giving sun. Despite their beauty by human standards, they are monstrous creatures with black souls revealed through psychic sight, perpetually craving the psychic energy of anguish and torment to fill their emptiness. Unlike their craftal Eldari counterparts, the Drukhari disdain integrating their potent psychic abilities into their culture. They reject psychers, and their use might attract the attention of She Who Thirsts, Slaanesh, putting their souls at further risk of being consumed by the Chaos God. Kamara, known as the Dark City, stands at the colossal city-state nestled within the Webway, serving as the principal home of the Drukhari. A kindred of the Eldari species, shrouded in mystery, it is deemed impossible for outsiders to discover, and inhabitants embrace anarchy and terrorism as integral aspects of their debased lifestyle. Within the holy pathways of the Craftor Eldari, Kamara is perceived as a dark stain, growing within the interdimensional labyrinth known as the Webway. More than a mere metropolis, Kamara dwarfs the greatest cities of real space, akin to a soaring mountain compared to a mound of termites. Its dimensions defy conventional understanding, featuring a population exceeding that of entire star systems. Kamara appears as a vast amalgamation of satellite realms and cities interconnected by myriad portals and hidden pathways. From a certain viewpoint, Kamara resembles a malevolent virus spread throughout the arteries of the Webway. Although physically scattered across the galaxy, these concentrations are linked by shimmering dimensional shortcuts, enabling swift traversal between sub-realms. The Dark City is notorious for its wandering shadows that tear apart the unwary, and bathe in the crimson half-light of the Lamea, or Black Suns. These dying stars, seized from real space during the height of Eldari technological prowess, illuminate Kamara and provide it with power, existing within their sub-realms within the Webway. During the final weeks of the 13th Black Crusade led by Abaddon the Despoiler, in approximately 999 Millennium 41, the Craftor Eldari deliberately collapsed several Webway portals leading to Kamara. This action isolated the Dark City from much of the Webway. Despite this, the Drukhari can still employ artificial Webway portals within their technological infrastructure to create temporary tunnels through the warp, ensuring they remain largely unaffected by their Craftworld counterparts' actions due to the mutable nature of the Webway. The fall of the Eldari marks the catastrophic event that befell the Eldari race during the early 30th millennium of the Terran calendar, leading to the demise of their dominance in the Milky Way galaxy. This epochal incident gave rise to the Chaos God Slaanesh and the subsequent emergence of the present-day Eldari factions, including the Craftor Eldari, Asuriani, the Drukhari, and the Rustic Exodites. The Eldari, an ancient and enigmatic humanoid alien species, once wielded vast influence across the galaxy. Their empire spanned eons, shaping the destinies of worlds and manipulating cosmic forces. However, the Eldari's zenith crumbled into oblivion, reducing them to near extinction and scattering the remnants of their shattered civilization into constant warfare. Those who retained enough sanity fled on mighty vessels known as Craftworlds, becoming the last vestiges of the once mighty Eldari civilization drifting amidst the stars. While the Eldari seldom speak openly about their calamitous past, fragments of the story can be gleaned from various sources. The Eldari succumbed to extremes of experience, their heightened senses perceiving the zeniths of agony and ecstasy. The intensity of emotion coalesced within the Immaterium, giving rise to a new chaos power, Slaanesh. This entity slumbered, fueled by Eldari excess, and as their deeds intensified, the Eldari plunged further into extremes. Ultimately, the Eldari sank into depravity, and Slaanesh awoke, its birth cries decimating the race. The Chaos God consumed the spirits of billions of Eldari, unleashing destruction upon their empire. The warp erupted into real space, creating the Eye of Terror, a vast corrupted wound upon the fabric of reality. The Eye of Terror, now home to the darkest evils of the galaxy, serves as the battleground for the Great Game, an eternal struggle among Chaos factions. The traitor legions, driven from Terra during the Horus Heresy, have claimed homeworlds within the Eye of Terror. Abaddon the Despoiler, a former lieutenant of Horus, has united these disparate factions in Black Crusades, terrorizing Imperial sectors. The Eye of Terror, born from the Eldari's shame and the price of their fall, distorts time within its bounds, enabling traitor legions to menace the Impidium for 10,000 standard years. 10 millennia after the Horus Heresy, as traitor legions embark on Black Crusades, the Eldari mourn their lost glory and fear that the folly of mankind may replicate their arrogance, heralding dire consequences for the galaxy. Lore lovers, this is the end of the second part of this introduction in Warhammer 40k lore. Thank you for joining me on this expansive journey to the rich tapestry of the Warhammer 40k universe here on the Lion Drag channel. If you found this exploration into the grim darkness of the far future intriguing, don't forget to express your enthusiasm by smashing that like button, sharing this video with fellow lore enthusiasts, and subscribing to Lion Drag for an ongoing odyssey to the vast lore of Warhammer 40k. For deeper discussions, lore theories, or just to connect with fellow enthusiasts, be sure to join our Discord server. The link is in the description below. Your passion and insights make this community thrive. As we delve further into the mysteries of the 41st millennium, I'm Lion Drag, your guide through the lore. Until next time, may the Emperor's Light guide you, lore lovers.